He and three mates were kings of the world.
Outside the Empire Theatre in London, the fans have been queuing for hours for a night of rock and roll history. Some have stepped out of the past. Others have come to see what all the fuss was about. The fourth Beatle is amongst old friends.
Ready? Here we go.
Let's go.
And if Ringo Starr looks relaxed, it's because he has done this once or twice before.
Please welcome Ringo Starr and his all-star band!
Presumably, you really don't have to do it anymore.
Well, no, I don't have to do it, but I do it, because this is what I do. You know, my soul and my occupation is syncopation. And that's what I love to do, you know. I'm blessed, actually, that because of those days, that I'm still doing it. In a time.
Ringo was never much of a singer, but the crowd's happy to help out. They know all the words to all the songs. Songs, Ringo says, only get better with age. When you listen to Beatles music now, does it still sound good to you?
Yeah, it does. Yeah. And it's interesting, the further away from it, the better it sounds, because I can get rid of all the emotion of the day and the happenings and just listen to it as a record, like I listen to anybody else's. You know, I don't know what torture they went through to make it. I just listen to that 3, 4, 5 minute track and enjoy it or not enjoy it for what it I get at that moment. And it's like that with the Beatles tracks. I'm still buying the records. So that's the joy for me.
The new generation of Beatles fans will never understand, though, the mania of those 8 years when the Beatles ruled the world. And from the inside, it was even crazier. Little time apart, little privacy, and for the man with the invented name, celebrity undreamt of.
It's been a very good name, hasn't it?
Yeah.
It has had a certain
John
ring to
Paul
it.
John Paul George and Ringo.
Was George Harrison your best mate in the Beatles?
Most of the time, yeah.
Do you know why? Was it?
I don't know, there's four of us, I don't know. I'm an only child, so they're all my brothers. I mean, and John and I lived in the same area, so we spent a lot of time together. Paul and I shared many rooms as we toured, you know, because we'd only have two rooms between the four of us. So it moved around, but through the whole deal, George is still like the pal, you know, to this day.
I love me in the beginning of this.
I live my life.
When Ringo went back to the studio to record his first album in years, George lay in the lead guitar and he brought Paul in to do bass and some vocals. La-di-da.
I told you he could do it.
Well, George is on it and Paul's on it and Joe Walsh is on it and Brian Wilson's on it.
It was a wide open door you had there.
Well, that's what they say. It's an open door policy. If you knock on the door, you're on the record. What in the
world would I do? Whenever the surviving Beatles get together, it's like the years have been stripped away. What no one can take from them is the bond, forged by years of living outrageously.
We're the only people who can look at each other and really know what it means to actually have been in that band. Nobody else knows. You know, it was pretty scary sometimes. I mean, you know, we had no life of our own. We were sort of, you know, every minute there was someone trying to get something from you. And, you know, it was just the four of us going through this.
Do you recall Your trip to Australia?
Oh, yeah.
You have a memory of it?
Yeah, I do, because the first thing someone said, you know, that's the big man. As soon as I got off the plane, never been there before, someone said, how do you like it here? I said, well, I just got off the plane. You got to give me a minute.
Sorry.
Hello, hello, hello.
Welcome to Australia. How do you feel about being here?
Oh, it's great. It's been fun, you know. Thank God I'm off that plane.
And what are you...
I see.
What are you looking forward to most seeing in Australia?
I don't know. Everything in general, you know. I'd like to see a few Maoris and that, and a few kangaroos. He's getting worried now, isn't he? He's run out of questions. Doesn't know what's happening. Have you been at it long?
No, not very long.
Good. Yeah. That's it, one more thing. It's very nice for all of us to have back with us now, Ringo.
Can you imagine what it would be like if you hadn't been that Beatle?
No. No idea. That's how it was, so that's how it is, you know. Let it be written.
No regrets at all?
No, you can't regret it. You know, I mean, that's the life you've led, and this is where you've ended up, around this table, talking to you.
I don't snore.
You do, repeatedly.
Do I snore, John?
Yeah, you're a window rattler, son.
One of Ringo's legacies from those Beatle years was a second job. In their debut film, A Hard Day's Night, Ringo proved that he was the Beatle who could act. There was a Chaplin-like quality to his performance.
Nasty little person, you.
Yeah. That's a splendid nose.
Mm. 17th century?
Easily.
And excellent. Before long, Ringo was cast in Great Comedy Company.
No. Come, young one, let's go and watch the auction.
And keep your eye open for a good ear.
In one of his movies, Caveman, Ringo got the girl. Barbara Bach caught his eye, which isn't surprising. And their marriage is still strong after 17 years, which is surprising.
I am a romantic, and I'm blessed that the woman loves me and I love her.
It's been one of those great unions.
Yeah, it's magic.
Being a celebrity, being famous, is that a problem?
No, not today. It's just how it is.
The reason I ask, though, is that John Lennon was shot dead.
Well, you can't live like that. I mean, you can't live thinking, oh, it might be me.
It frighten you?
Oh, it terrified me. You know, immediately we all had bodyguards. And then we got rid of them, because what are they going to do? You know, they can't save the Pope. They couldn't save the President. You know, I mean, you got to get on with your life and just live it.
But it wasn't as easy as it sounds. After the Beatles split, Ringo and his wife Barbara did nothing but drugs and booze. It was 8 years, and only after Ringo began to suffer blackouts, before they decided to sober up.
There was a heavy period in the 80s where alcohol became... I became dependent on it.
Can you explain how that happened? How does...
Well, you don't know how it happens, really. You think you're having fun, and you think you're having a drink, and then you end up that's all you're doing. It just sort of sneaks up on you in many, you know, in a way, really. You just find yourself in this madness, this merry-go-round, this train, just going downhill, and you got a drink, you got to have a drug, you got to do this. That you feel that's the only, in my case, I felt that's the only way I could live.
Do you recall how you stopped it?
I went into a rehab and they actually showed me a way I didn't have to drink every day, you know, anymore if I didn't want to. And that was, oh, great, okay. I mean, for me, I feel blessed that it's like my second life, really, this one. And, you know, it's full of good things.
Thank you. Okay, I'd like to do another for you now called Act Naturally.
Ringo says he's never been fitter. It's been a decade since his last drink. He's kicked a 3-pack-a-day cigarette habit and works out every day. When he's not touring, he's living an all-natural life at home in Monte Carlo.
All we gotta do is act to be.
And you do cook.
I love to cook. I love to cook. I'm there like a mother hen. Ooh, do this and ooh, put that in. Put the. Ooh, it's time for that. Okay.
What yeah. is it? Why?
I don't know. It's just I love it. You know, I mean, I have no reason for it. I mean, you know, it's just that it's a thing of joy for me. And it's not like I can put something in the oven or put the pan on and like wander off and do something else. It's like I have to be there.
Do you have a favorite dish you'd like to?
Well,
pass
I have
on.
A great bean and veg soup, I do.
Is that right?
Yeah, I love that.
And when it rains, I don't complain. I'm like a train, I just keep rolling on.
At 58 and a grandfather, Ringo's not planning a big-time comeback. He's happy with the way things are. After all, he's already been as big as they come.
Da-dee-da.
When you look in the mirror, what do you see?
Well, I see now, you see, at one point I didn't like to look in the mirror because I just didn't like what's there. Now you can't keep me away. I'm like, yeah, go on, keep it up.
You see a Ringo Starr, or do you see Richard Starkey?
No, I always see Richard Starkey. But what I do see is I see a person who enjoys getting up now in the morning, heading through the day, and that's the difference.
Hey, sir.